This is how we roll. Ho, 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 ho. I do not own the rights to that stupid song. This is how we roll. Oh, there I go again. Some boy right there shredding out. Getting that cardiovascular workout. Rip. Rip, brother. Take a ride, son. So, let's talk about friendship. Brutal honesty. There's a reason why they call it brutal honesty, because you're not walking on eggshells. You're less concerned with offending your friend and giving him constructive advice and just being honest with him. Cut the bullshit. Now, if someone isn't worried about your best interest, if someone doesn't want to see you progress, if someone doesn't want to see you maximize your potential, then they're not your friend. I generally put people like that into three categories: need, want, and can use. But I will say this, if they don't have your best interest at heart, if they don't want what's best for you, if they don't want to see you progress, like I said, if they don't want to see you maximize your potential, and certainly if you can't learn anything from them, they're not your friend. Think about what you want, not what you don't. Think about what you want to do, not what you don't want to do. Think about why you want to do it, not why you don't want to do something else. Approach everything the exact same way. Do what you want. Do what you want. It's even better when the people that you care about can benefit from it. And if that's your incentive, you can't lose. If it don't involve money, then I don't accept. Number two, don't be a dick, all right? Here's an example. I was riding my bike, as I do a lot, down the road, so I decided to get on the sidewalk, and I can see someone jogging towards me on the same sidewalk. So I get on the right side to allow him to pass on my left. Well, he wouldn't move over, and I could see him about 40 yards up. I could see that it was gonna turn into a game of chicken. All right, so, and he was jogging. I could tell he was a fighter. I can tell. I'm around fighters all the time because I work with them, I train them, I learn from them, et cetera, et cetera. So he wanted to play chicken. Well, I didn't really get that that's what he was trying to do until I got closer to him. So we get just about right up on each other, and he decides he's not gonna move. So at the last second, I swerve over onto the grass a little bit. I got some biking skills, you know how X does it. No, that's how I get down. Can't fade me, baby boy. So as I pass him, I yell at him and I say, hey, get on your right. And then I realize something. It wasn't so much that he was being a dick. Number one, he was on the left side of the sidewalk. Well, he's probably not American. Not that that really matters. Okay. The problem is that I was on the sidewalk and I really wasn't supposed to be. Technically, it's a sidewalk, not a side ride. So, a combination of both of our machismo attitudes, because deep down inside, we all have it. Males do, at least. I can speak for us. Hispanic males. To narrow it down, it doesn't mean that it's not in there. It just means that I control it. We all do. The better the person, or the better you desire to be, the more control you have. So, even if he would have moved out of my way, I would have still lost, because I was wrong. Which brings me to my next point. When you are wrong, learn how to admit it. When you're wrong, learn how to admit it. It's liberating. You're not always gonna be right. And that's just the thing. Be willing to be wrong. Be willing to fail. But don't be so afraid to be wrong, or don't be so afraid to fail that you end up doing nothing, because life is short, brother. So make it good. Here I am riding my bike down this old bike trail. Just the other day, I was 14 doing the same thing. And I ain't 14 anymore. My daughter is. Like this. All right, when you're out and about, you run into friends. Joey's in the house.
Hey.
Joey Edgley.
I love what you've done with the place.
Same old Joe, he's out working. This is what he does. He's a mover and a shaker.
New All look right. construction right here. Right here, Memorial Parkway.
Joey's from Boston,
yeah.
but
Good
you guys
to see
know
you,
that.
X.
You too, brother.
And your boy.
That's right. Back
Heck
here,
yeah.
we're getting ripped.
There he is, little X.
That's what we're doing this morning.
It's good.
All right.
Sweat, sweat, sweat. All about that exercise.
Hell yeah.
You gotta keep it moving and shaking. Bodies in motion tend to stay in motion. That is a super overused cliche. Well, why? Because it's true. A philosopher once talked about the art of 10,000 times. Whatever it is that you do 10,000 times, you master it. If you do nothing 10,000 times, guess what? If you walk your dog 10,000 times, you know all the ins and outs of walking your dog. You know how to do a perimeter scan. You know how to look out for other dogs. You know when he needs to go and what number it is. You have experience because you've done it 10,000 times. The same thing goes for everything. So if you haven't done whatever it is that you're passionate about 10,000 times, get after it. Speaking of which, that's my cardio. It's time to crunk it. And as you know, I came to get down.
That was my next lesson. Don't hold back. Don't be afraid to apply your full power. All right? If you have to, surround yourself with people. That was just powerful. I'm X, coming to you from Katy, Texas.
That's how I roll around town. X on the ones and twos. As in front wheel and back wheel. God, joke sucked. All right, surround yourself with people that are gonna make you better. Surround yourself with people that recognize your gifts and what you have to offer. And then share it with them. Not with anybody that's gonna hold you back. That's ridiculous, you know. They may have something that appeals to you, but when you compare it to what they have that slows you down or holds you back, you know, just make a wise decision. Again, wisdom comes with trying and failing. Wisdom comes with trying and doing and winning. It's experience. So choose wisely. The cool thing about choosing is you can re-choose as often as you want. All right, that's it for me. It's your good friend X. I'll see y'all next time. Peace. All right, back at the house. I'm gonna get some chicken, some corn tortillas. All right, these aren't for me, these are for the boy. I just going with chicken this morning. A little bologna, straight protein, brother. That's how we do it. All right, you want some gains? You want to get ripped? You want some bulk?
Bologna made with chicken.
Want to pump? Which reminds me of my opinion on diet, okay? Diet isn't about what you don't eat. It's not about what you don't consume. It's about what you do. All right, and it's not just about the food that you intake. It's about all the information that goes into your brain. Because whatever it is that you put in your body, let's say food-wise, it's brutally obvious what it is because it shows on the outside. You can don't try in front, guys. If you are severely out of shape, it's because of what you eat. All right, it's not because of what you don't. It's because of what you eat. Period. All right. I know some of you guys might say, well, so-and-so's got a thyroid issue, or so-and-so's got, I don't know, spina bifida. I'm just making stuff up, whatever the case is. I mean, in general, you know where I'm going with this, all right? Don't be an excuse maker. I'm just saying. Now, whatever information goes into your head, whatever you listen to, whatever you watch, the company you keep, your friends, all right, whatever goes in, whatever information comes in, you're going to end up regurgitating that. Whatever recipe your brain puts together with all the information that you have, that's part of your diet as well. Your mental intake. It goes in, it's gonna come out. So, feed your brain wisely. All right? Right, buddy?
Yeah.
All about what you put in. Whatever you put in, that's what comes out. Gains, brother. Protein. Chicken time. All right? It's your brother X. See y'all next time.
What did you put in here?
It's pre-workout. I'm old. That's how I have to wake up.